aboard the Kolfage at Chatham County, Kent. The first day of October for Johnson's Harbor bent, commanded by MacDonald, who always fast times makes. Aboard the schooner Kolfage, Columbia of the Lakes, the tug Vic took our line at 12 o'clock at night, and down the Thames we towed amid the moonbeam's somber light. But when on Lake St. Clair, boys, the wind came dead ahead, so we put the big hook out and all went off to bed. Next morning we hoisted sail in a fresh wind from the east. The Kolfage plowed the lake through billows white as yeast. We headed for the cut with all our sails unfurled. With bending masts we tried to smash the record of the world. A steamer hove alongside and we ran her neck and neck. Straight into the cut, my lads, our speed we would not check. We struck her starboard bow for to keep us off of the bank, and her fender scrumped along her side, we fetched up with a yank. Angry words flew in the air, their speed they had to check. We damn near had a fight right then, each man was on the deck. We cursed them high and low, oh, they threatened to come aboard. Put the wind all to the southward, and up the river we roared. And Sarnia we reached late afternoon that day. The wind again contrary, so we anchored in the bay. We towed out on the morning just about a mile or so, with the cataract and Vienna boat from Lake Ontario. Action, a race it was to be. Those Lake Ontario clippers, they claimed supremacy. With all our canvas set, boys, we ran off like a steer. And when the night came on, they were far off to our rear. Next day we reached Southampton and we anchored off the shore, just inside of the harbor while the lake outside did roar. And there the schooner Fulton, inside the harbor we found, in a waterlogged condition and also hard aground. At dawn we heaved our anchor and hoisted sail once more. Northward up the lake, just off the rocky shore. We sailed along the cape before a southwest breeze, and ran into the bay among the lumber piles and trees. Came down right then along the ridge of rock, and we got out our dinner, for we were feeling like. But the old man introduced us to some 24-foot plank. Before we started with the planks, so bags we had to tote, and 20 barrels of flour from the bosom of the boat. We hoisted up that flour till our fingers began to swell, but we gladly hauled the flour again, those planks they gave us hell. Now the vessel is loaded and we are here on shore, and all the planks and lumber we will handle nevermore. Rounds the bend and she disappears from view. It's goodbye, Cap MacDonald. Here's our best regards to you.